O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Great and amazing are your deeds, O Lord God the Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O King of the nations. Who will not fear you, O Lord, and glorify your name? For you alone are holy. All nations will come and worship you, for your righteous acts have been revealed.
The author of salvation.
based on the Psalter. I'd like to share with you one of the quotes from the Fathers of the Reformation, Martin Luther, what he said about Psalms and how that helps us in worship. He says, "But what is the chief subject of the Psalms, if it is not the earnestness of language in all the storms and contradictions of life? Where shall we find words more adapted to express joy than what is contained in the Psalms of thanksgiving and of praise? And where do we find more profound expressions of melancholy and of sorrow than are contained in the Psalms of affliction and mourning? In them we find the two great passions, fear and hope. And we find them depicted in language which no painter could express, and which the greatest human actor could never outdo." The Psalms lead us to rest on God. So I will read now another prayer from the Valley of Vision. This is called Resting on God. It's one of my favorites. Let us pray. O God most high, most glorious, the thought of your infinite serenity cheers us. For we are toiling, troubled and distressed, but you are forever at perfect peace. Your designs cause you no fear or worry. They stand fast as the eternal hills. Your power knows no limit, your goodness no boundary. You bring order out of confusion, and my defeats are your victories. The Lord God, omnipotent, reigns. We come to you as sinners with cares and sorrows, to leave every concern entirely to you, every sin calling for Christ's precious blood. Revive deep spirituality in our hearts. Let us live near to the great shepherd, hear his voice, know its tones, follow its calls. Keep us from deception by causing us to abide in the truth, from harm by helping us to walk in the power of the Spirit. Give us greater faith in eternal realities, burning into us by experience the things that we know. Grant us to know that we truly live only when we live in and through and to you, that all else is trifling. Your presence alone can make us holy, devoted, strong, and happy. Abide in us, gracious God.
From the ashes.
and nations at his feet. He breaks the bow and bends the spear and tells the wars to cease. O mighty one of Israel,
I'm praying these phrases to the Lord, and in a little while we'll sing our next song.
Thank you.
my soul is still before the Lord. He is my rock and my salvation, my fortress strong. I trust in Him. I'll not be shaken. I'll not be shaken. For all my hope is in His love. From God alone comes my salvation. I'll wait and trust in steadfast love.
Yo.
time to look at Psalm 40. Let's pray these lines to the Lord, and we will come together and sing again in a few moments. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. the humble hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Those who look to him are radiant, and their faces shall never be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all of his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who takes refuge in him.
Coming.
Jesus said, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Rock of ages, cleft for me, let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from thy wounded side flow. Be of sin the double cure, save from wrath and make me pure. None of the labors of my hands can fulfill thy lost demands. Could my zeal or rest in
simply to the cross I cling. Make it come to thee for trust. Countless blood to thee for grace. Foul I to the fountain fire. Wash me, Savior, I die. Bleeding breath, when my eyes shall close in death, when I soar to worlds unknown, see thee on thy judgment throne. Rock of ages, cleft for me, let me hide myself in
Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who, in every respect, was tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need.
Rise, my soul, arise, shake off your guilty fears. The bleeding sad on my behalf appears. Before the throne my surety stands, before the throne my surety stands. My name is written on its head.
smile is pardoning both I need. He owns me as his child. I can no longer fear. With confidence I now draw nigh. With confidence I now draw nigh. And Father, Abba,
song, and it's a favorite here at URC. We did it for the first time on Easter this year, and it's the final piece of the equation in rest, because rest comes when we are with the Lamb who was slain, who gave his life for us. True eternal rest is waiting for us with the Lamb who is worthy. So let us sing, He is Worthy.
Know that all all creation groaning.
It is
a new creation coming.
It
is the glory of the Lord be the light within our midst.
It
is it good that we remind ourselves? Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slain. Is he worthy? Does the Father truly love us?
He does.
Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And does Jesus our Messiah hold forever those he loves?
He does.
Does our God intend to dwell again with us? Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slain. Every people and tribe,
ask you tonight, might we know more fully and more beautifully how holy and how worthy you are. Would you press it deeply down into our hearts until we overflow with peace and confidence and joy in your promises. You are a God who makes big promises, and you are a God who keeps your promises. So as we leave tonight, as we go through our summer, as we put our hope in you, please guide us, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.